Hey, what's up guys? Tyler here with Secureteam. So we have a developing story here. After a couple of pilots, two separate pilots who were flying over the skies of England spotted something that up until now, they don't have an explanation for. Apparently, this sighting was so mysterious that the pilots themselves posted to Facebook looking for further answers. And so this strange incident occurred just above the city of Gloucester, where we had two Air Midwest aircraft reporting that this mysterious encounter took place as both of them were, quote, conducting night navigation exercises at around 8:15 in the evening. The pilots in both planes saw what they called, quote, one red and one orange light in the sky south of Gloucester. One of the aircraft attempted to intercept the strange lights to determine what they were, where they came from. However, the pursuit proved to be futile, as apparently the strange lights or objects were able to evade the aircraft. And so here you're seeing the Facebook post. I'm not sure if this may be an image of the lights taken from the aircraft. I'm not sure here. It doesn't say that I can tell, at least yet. But I'll read you from the actual Facebook post, courtesy of Air Midwest, describing the strange event. It states, quote, "There has been a lot of interest in the fact that our pilots observed UFOs last night during night flying exercises. So here's a brief summary of the situation. They described the event as unidentified airborne nocturnal lights. Two of our aircraft were conducting night navigation exercises to the south and southeast of our home airfield. At approximately 2:15, one of our aircraft was tracking south towards Gloucester at 7,000 feet after leaving the Birmingham air traffic zone. At the same time, one of our other aircraft was also tracking south towards Gloucester at 4,000 feet when both aircraft observed one red and one orange light in the sky south of Gloucester. Our aircraft approached the lights on an interception track but were unable to gain on the objects as they appeared to move further south of Gloucester as our aircraft approached. We were unable to identify the lights. One of our pilots filed the following report on the event. I observed initially two large square orange lights, one on top of each but slightly offset. However, there was a gap in height between them. The top object was constantly orange. The lower one occasionally flickered white, but majority of the time was orange. In addition to that, on two occasions, I observed five more lights, but that was momentary. I initially observed them when leaving Birmingham control zone. I thought they were just south of Gloucester and definitely a lot higher than us. We then climbed 5,000 feet and they seemed level at that height and stationary. We climbed 7,000 feet and commenced a turn to observe the lights. At this point, they seemed lower than us, but in the same place and were still stationary. So whatever these things were, they weren't moving. A lot of these strange objects, UFOs, they will sit static in the sky, which allows you to rule out balloons or some of the more natural things that are more sensitive to the effects of air, gravity, and things of that nature. The pilot finishes with, "I have no idea what these objects were," and that's all I can say on the matter. Could they have been night glow balloons? It's unlikely, as these do not move very fast at all. So what were they? We have no idea. An interesting event. So that's what they posted to Facebook. So it appears they encountered multiple lights here that at some points would climb thousands of feet. They would sit still and stationary at times, and at other times pick up great speed and were able to outmaneuver the pilots. So they couldn't even get up on this thing, whatever it was, and get a better shot. Now, the way they describe these lights also make me think that this wasn't a balloon. We have some lights in a sort of a square formation stacked on top of one another. And from what the pilots have said here, from what they saw with their own eyes, there is no natural explanation that they can think of. So I'd like to put the word out, anybody over Gloucester, seen anything strange? Anyone in the UK? You know, we've been seeing a lot of strange sightings and testimony coming from pilots lately, which in my opinion is some of the best UFO testimony you can get, because these things are up there, they're in these aircraft, and they can see these things. Sometimes they chase them. And we've spoken about other stories recently where these objects have been stalking aircraft and aircraft carriers off the coast of California, again, sitting stationary in the sky, having the ability to move at breakneck speeds and descend from thousands of feet high in a matter of seconds. So, very, very mysterious sighting. I thought you guys would like to know about it. I'll definitely keep up, and in any updates I have, we will post in a future video. So, tell me what you guys think. Stay tuned, stay safe, and I'll see you back in just a bit.